us bugging.
How y'all doing out there? This is G-Man with Jeff's Bugging. The 74 Super Beetle, dual port 1600, and as you can see, it's upside down. I got the holes plugged up and I'm cleaning it up, scrubbing all the grease out of all the holes and the fins. It was a mess. I got the tens out here, cleaned the oil cooler, flush it out. I'm gonna get all this stuff ready for sandblasting. And yes, I will be opening this up and replacing both sets of grommets. I've seen it before where people see this one and they replace these two and they don't replace these other two. We've got some tens in here. I had to repair one. As you can see, I had to locate the other tens that he's missing, and somebody had trimmed this off for some reason, so I cut it from a single port one that I have and probably never going to use. And it was chrome and rusted, so I didn't care about cutting it up. I'll fix that up, put some putty in there, make it look nice. That's where we are at with this. I've got another one coming in, so I want to get this one done and over with. And another one that I want to refresh and paint it up to match the car. Anybody out there that wants one done, I'm your man. There we go, guys. It's looking good. Box all cleaned off. If you're wondering why I haven't taken the pulley off yet, is I'm gonna clean a little bit better behind that when I get my puller out. And feel like messing with it today. Got it all cleaned up and everything, and ready to. I'm gonna go. You know, I gotta take it further and take the push rod tubes out, but it was just easier to clean around that and then finish it up when I have them out, so I don't have to get water inside the motor. And then I go ahead and drain it and flush it with some oil right now, because you know, you do get a little in there possibly, you know. And then I'm going to start sandblasting this week as soon as we have a good day where it's not raining like it is always in Florida. Unusually more rain this year for December. It is a beautiful January 1st, 2020. I hope you all had a great New Year's Eve. I'm back to the 74 Super Beetle, the one that I pulled the motor out and it had the bell housing, motor mount bolt, whichever one you call, want to call it, broke out. Well, like I said, we're going to do a repair that's the best we can do. Is the neighbor's going to try to attempt to weld that into that area. So the motor assembly is going to be delayed a little bit until he gets done with that. And down in the car, I made the suggestion that we need to deal with this tail pan area. I mean, it's not that difficult to pull one of these motors. I don't understand why somebody would cut the tail pan off like this, apron, whatever you want to call it. But you can see it still has remnants of the old one, so I'm going to jack this up, put it on some stands, and go ahead and remove these fenders. And then I've got to close these areas up with some metal, strip this off of it, and then I'm going to pull these seals out. I mean, people just don't understand. All of this is very important for the cooling system. I mean, you spend all this money on the motor, you need to give it a good area to run properly in and cool properly. Of course, it's extremely important. This is the second time I've seen this. There's another Super Beetle coming in Saturday that I'm going to be pulling, refresh, and detailing the motor like this one. And look at this. This is a huge mistake. Never run this rubber line for your fuel line. I mean, and it's coming over the 10. The other one is laying on the 10. The only thing that's saving it somewhat is the titanium sock wrap that's on it. Other than that, it would have just burnt the car to the ground sitting on top of the 10 right over the exhaust. So this is a big no-no. It should be a metal line, and it comes all the way in here. See, this is a metal line right here, and it comes in. It's got to go over the intake underneath here and then come up here, and then it stops, and you put the rubber line on it here. I mentioned that the other day. I want to see if I can kind of move this maybe up in here somewhere. This fuel filter is kind of not a good idea to have it right beside the coils from what I've been hearing, so that makes sense. And then you see I put a rubber hose over the metal line and run it up in and up to here, and then I put titanium wrap on it. So I'm not going to have a vapor lock issue. I'm not going to have a fire issue. You know, I'll move that. I never had a problem with it before, but it makes good sense. If I could get it back there a little bit, you know, if you ever got a spark from here and you had a little bit of fuel residue over here, poof, there goes all your work. So, stand somewhere else. All right, here. My guy that was supposed to build my booth slash additional shop has had some vehicle problems with both of his vehicles, and I hope he's still going to follow through with his part of the deal. But hate that when that happens. Him and I are really discharged soldier, Desert Storm War veteran, so my word means everything to me. Everyone should be that way. All right, enough of my BS. Let's get back to this. A little makeshift remover works really well. All of them, standard or super. Hope everybody saw that tearjerker of a last goodbye to the Beatle yesterday. I was watching Times Square New Year's Eve celebration. That was pretty neat, along with Post Malone. Well, I understand why the right side running board's not on now. Hadn't been down here to look at it, and at the rear of the car. Look at that massive plate of steel. I mean, look at that. Great. I've got to match the apron with it, so I'm gonna have to attempt to paint improperly metallic base to match this improperly painted metallic base. Alright, got all the fenders put away and the tires put away. I'm gonna clean up some of this paint. Alright, now I'll go get my spot weld drill bit and drill the 30 or 40 of these out. Air chisel and cutting wheel and everything else it takes to get it off. All right, got my trusty spot weld drill bit set up. Spot welds, that worked out nice, didn't it?
Little pesky varmint. See what you gotta do it correct.
Look at there. Now, grind all that off and we'll be set. Safety first. Gotta wear your proper PPE. Well, that'll do for that. I got those off. Spot welds all grinded off. Oh, I have to do now. I'm not gonna do it today because I gotta go jump to my next project. I gotta get ready to get in the paint booth. I'm going to get this thing ready to put on there after I weld those in. But I was wondering how much of my, track for the deck load seal. See, they cut this off right where it ends, and that ends right there, so good, it's all there. And I gotta cut those holes out there. I mean, there's some crazy stuff done to this, but I guess not too bad, I guess. Weld all those two holes up. Get this fitted on there correctly. And it should be good. I'm gonna put the fenders back on, you know, just temporarily to make sure it all lines up perfectly at the end. And then take the fenders back off and get this welded in there. And then we will have a complete engine seal, which is very important. Alrighty, until next time, stay tuned for progress on the 74 Super Beetle. And you all have a great day, and I hope you have a happy new year. This is G-Man out. Just bugging.